Let's do an example of linearization in multivariable calculus. Consider this function here. U of x and t is 1 over the square root of t times e to the negative x squared over 4t. I claim that there's some background information about this function, namely it arises in the study of the heat equation. But set that aside for a moment. What we would like to do is linearize this function at 0, 1. So the goal is to be able to say that if we are near that point, so near xt equals 0, 1, the function u of x and t, is approximated by its first order linear approximation, L of x and t. So it's like we can approximate u with a different function, which will be computed as u at that point plus the gradient of u at that point dot the vector x minus 0, t minus 1. Let's see what we can go ahead and say about this right-hand side. All right, so x is 0, t is 1, 1 over the square root of 1 is 1, e to the negative x squared over 4t, well, that x is 0, so that's e to the 0, that's also 1. So actually, this first term is 1. The gradient we will need to compute in just a moment. So for now, let me just say that this will be the x partial derivative of u evaluated at 0, 1, times this first component, which is actually just x, plus the t partial derivative at 0, 1, times the second component, which is actually going to be t minus 1. Nothing we're being told about the heat equation is necessary for this computation. However, if you look at this function, think about whether it would be more pleasant to differentiate this function with respect to x or with respect to t, because I claim that one of them is better. And then think about, like, okay, if one of them is unpleasant, is there another way to get to that? All right, hopefully you're following this riddle that I'm trying to spell out for you. Let's pause for a moment and go ahead, identify which partial derivative is nicer and take that partial derivative. Hopefully there's a consensus that since t is actually in two denominators and inside of a square root, that's going to be like quotient rule with square root, that doesn't look quite as nice as differentiating this function with respect to x. So let's go ahead and compute the x partial derivative of u. In general, u sub x, the first term, 1 over square root of t, we'll just leave that alone, treat it like a constant. And then we're differentiating an exponential function. So first thing we do is just kind of rewrite that exponential function. And now I need to differentiate this. But it's not too bad because we have x squared in the numerator here. So that's going to come down, be negative 2x over 4t. So let me write that as negative x over 2t. There, divided the top and bottom by 2. Okay, so that is the term that we need here. Let me go ahead and actually compute that now with at the point 0, 1. So this is going to be 1. This is going to be e to the 0, which is also 1. And then this is actually 0, so it's 0. Okay, we have a decision to make. We can either differentiate u with respect to t to get this term, or because of the heat equation, we can say that, you know, given that this function solves this heat equation, it's the case that if I want this t partial derivative, then I can actually instead choose to differentiate this again with respect to x. That's what I'm going to do, again, because I've already got two terms here, so it's going to be product rule either way, but I like where x is situated in this expression more than I like where t is situated. Okay, so via the heat equation, I can say that this partial derivative with respect to t is actually differentiating this with respect to x. Again, we have product rule leaving this term out front. In fact, I'll just leave that entirely out front. This with the product rule is going to be e to the negative x squared over 4t times the derivative of the inside, which again is negative x over 2t, and then times this. So if you didn't follow what I just did, I left this alone and differentiated this exponential term. Moving along with the product rule, now I'm going to leave this alone and differentiate this. Which is just negative 1 over 2t. Okay. Now I can say what the t partial derivative at 0, 1 is. I think I can squeeze it here. This will be 1. So we have a leading factor of 1 out front. These cause this whole first expression to vanish because x is 0. Looking at the second term, we have e to the 0 again, so that's just 1. And then here, this will be negative 1 half because t is 1. So e to the 0 times negative 1 half overall leaves us with negative 1 half. I think that this is a better way to compute the t partial derivative of u than to literally do that because of, again, the fact that t is kind of living in denominators here. So the differentiation isn't going to be as nice as I think this was. At this point, we've done the heart of the problem. So we know that our x partial derivative at 0, 1, this term is going to be 0. This term is going to be negative 1 half. Let me, I was going to step aside and erase it, but actually, let me just finish it right here. We are done because this is 0. This is negative 1 half. So we have 1 plus 1 half is 3 halves, and then minus t over 2. If you would like to approximate u of x and t, where your input is near 0, 1, so maybe like 0.2 and 0.98, you could use this approximation instead. And that's just an easier function to work with than u as it was originally written. Okay, I hope you enjoyed looking at this computation and seeing how to use this fact about the heat equation to arrive at a nice form for the linearization.